Welcome, GMB Pros. Welcome, everyone that's here on the live. Carlos, Richard, we have Scott in the house. And those that are catching the replay, I appreciate you. I think we'll keep this one in-house. So no Facebook Live till the replay. So that'll be awesome. We have with my friend, Mr. Lee, here. Gosh, how did I meet Lee? It was in Vegas, in fact. Mm-hmm. Vegas at the
Digital Unfiltered.
Chris Palmer event. Yes, Digital Unfiltered. That's right. That's right. So, you know, there's different speakers. I haven't gone to many of these masterminds or gatherings, and this is one of the few that was super close, so I had to go. And Lee was actually one of my favorite. He has a way of explaining something that's difficult, super simple. And Lee has that gift. He has a gift of taking a dumb question or question he hears 1,000 times with understanding from where that person's coming from and really explain it and help you out. He really has a big heart, big giving heart. And Lee single-handedly elevated my SEO knowledge. So it's no secret. I used to only focus on GMB, GMB. That's all I did was GMB. And I like the way Lee spoke. It was about, you know, if you want to get into an affiliate, Lee has a formula that you can take a look at. And you can take a look at this formula he has and see if it's going to be profitable. And the way he explained it was like simple, effective, and simple, right? I think that's kind of Lee's motto. And, you know, we kind of connected, I told him what I did, what I was, you know, getting involved. He said, Alfred, you're working too hard, my friend. You're working too hard. He says, let me show you how to pull different levers to make life easier for you. And I got involved in his training program. And it's no secret, guys. One of the ways that I look at a program once I've gone through it is, you know, would I do it again? And hands down, in fact, Lee's having his training program again. And I got into it again, 100%. So Lee has taught me a lot. A lot of times you hear me give tips and different secrets and not even secrets, best practices, right? Lee took my best practice mindset steps and taught me how to think and how to implement those things. It's just best practices. And you don't need to get all mixed up in all these other stuff, just best practices. And Lee really elevated that for me. And I'm grateful. I consider him and his wife a friend and a colleague and somebody that is always has, you know, open hands, ears, willing to help me out. So I really appreciate Lee. Now, Lee, for those that don't know you or haven't seen you on other podcasts or the YouTube Fight Club or anywhere else, can you kind of give us a little background on yourself? How did you get to this point? A little bit about yourself.
I'll do that. It's pretty simple. I have been in SEO seriously for about 5 years, but I've been in SEO for about 15 years. And so I'm going to just distinguish those two things. My background is in database marketing, direct marketing. I'm a nerd. It's all data analysis, spinning, you know, large data sets, all of those kind of things. So I've done statistical modeling and testing for years. But when I got into internet marketing, I shut off that part of my brain that was, you know, looking at the data, being analytical, all those kind of things. And I would just listen to whoever out there was talking. So, you know, like a lot of you, I bought, you know, Warrior Forum courses for $17 thinking, yeah, this could probably get me a Lambo by Friday. It seems like a good deal. And, you know, I tried these things for years, all sorts of different software and courses and everything else, and nothing ever worked. And in 2018, I finally figured out that I could take all of the analytical skills that I was doing, you know, during my day job, so to speak, and apply it to SEO to try to figure out what really worked. And so I started doing a lot of large scale analysis, running a lot of tests to try to figure out, hey, you know, when these people say that this is true or this is how Google works, does it or doesn't it? And how well does it? Because not everything, you know, is the same. Not every factor in the algorithm is the same. As an example of that, we all know if you put your keyword in the title, it holds a lot more weight than if you bold it in the text. Both of those are factors. Both of those can move the needle. One just moves it a whole lot more than the other. So, I got into that, and that led me into a lot of different things, just different business, speaking engagements and stuff like that, because I didn't grow up in SEO. I brought a different analytical skill set, different analytical mindset to it. And honestly, I'm just lazy. So I always want to, if I can rank number one in 20 steps and then I figure out a way to do it in 15, I prefer 15 over 20. I prefer 10 to 15, those kind of things. And so when I see, like Alfredo was mentioning, he was talking about all these wonderful things that he was doing to rank his GMBs. And I'm like, dude, it's too many things. He was doing like 25 things. I'm like, you need to get that down to like, 15. And he's like, you can do that? And I'm like, yeah, let's talk, So that's kind of where Alfredo and I got, we got together, and hit it off. And, that's kind of my background. I just like figuring out, like puzzles, like figuring out Google. And, as soon as you establish a new benchmark, how do I beat it now? What would have to be true for me to rank better, faster, with less? So.
100%, absolutely, yes. So, guys, have you ever been on a conversation? Me and Lee got on a Zoom call, and like you felt like it was 5 minutes, and you turn around and look at the watch, and you were there 3 hours, right? You're like, holy smoke, you're just having fun. And me and Lee got into this thing and like interlinking, right? And he says, Alfred, check this out. Guys, when you hear me say simple, fast, and effective, that's Lee. If I ever give you a tip with those things in front or behind it, you guys know where it came from. But he's like, hey, this made a difference for a couple of tests that we did. And I said, Lee, you come on to the GMB Pros. You guys are all know the goal of the lives. It's either to help you grow your agency or help get results for your client. And we love to do it over the shoulder. So not only do you hear it, but you see it. And I want to just give the floor to Lee and just dive into this because guys, if you don't have a pen and a paper, bring it out. And this I guarantee will be a definitely a rewatcher for you.
Yeah, I had a little fun with Alfredo showing him this on, so even on some of his own stuff. And, so what I'm going to show you, internal linking is important, and it's important enough. I mean, first off, I can do a lot of tricks. I can move stuff, with links, traffic, and all these manipulations, and all these cool little fun things, and they're fun to figure out, and they're cool little tools to have in your toolbox. But internal linking can do things that it can move the needle on your rankings really, really fast. And I was shocked at how fast we were able to do it. My wife and I started looking at some of our own sites, and you'll see here in a minute. We ran some reports, took a look at the stuff, and I was like, oh, Jesus, Lee, do you know anything? I mean, it looks like you don't know anything when you look at the internal linking here and the way it was set up and everything else. And so with our sites and with, people we were helping out, we started showing them this process. And as soon as you change the internal linking, which you can do in a couple hours for most, especially if you're dealing with local sites tend to be a lot smaller, you can get site-wide rises without changing anything else on the pages. And when we saw that and saw it over and over again, I'm like, okay, so this is one of the two pieces where our process starts before I even change a page. I run a little technical audit just to make sure that there's nothing, with the parking brake on. And then I run this little internal linking thing and restructure internal links based on what I'm going to show you here today. So I'm going to get everybody started. So with this, all I need is Screaming Frog and Excel and your brain. That's it. So let's see. Alfredo, I'm going to let you pick a number between 21 and 30.
23.
23. All right. So we got a Michael Jordan number. Richard, I want you to pick a service, a home service category. It can be, plumber, electrician, whatever you want, sir.
Pest control.
Pest control. Love pest control. And Carlos, I'd like for you to pick a city. Any city you want.
Harlingen, Texas.
Harlingen?
Yes.
Beautiful. I don't know if there's 23 pest control companies in Harlingen, but we'll find out here in a second. So let me share screen. All right, so let's go here. We're going to do pest control. Harlingen, Texas. All right, so I'm going to go down here to number 23. So there's the first break. There's the second break. So 21, 22, 23. That's Angie. So you're going to have to go. We'll go with the next one. That's a Terminix. That's Terminix. That's a big one. So let's go. This dude, Safeguard PC McCallum. We good with that one? So let's take him. And I don't care about that. I just want his domain. We're going to go and get that. So Safeguard PC, let's copy him. And then we're going to go into Screaming Frog and we're going to let this one process in the background. All right, so let's boom. And let's let that start. So that's going to take a minute. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to get an output from this, and the output's going to look something like, do this. One second. Let me stop sharing for just a sec. Grab a couple of pieces here. Let me open these up so we have them in the background. And I'll show you what this looks like. These are ones that I did for a previous presentation. All right, share screen. All right, let's move this out of my way. All right, so when we get this stuff back out of Screaming Frog, we'll be doing this in just a minute. You can see out here, this is a link position. This is where the internal links are on this particular thing. So I'm going to sort this data, and you'll see this. This is not that hard to do. I'm going to sort it by link position because all I want ultimately is just the links in the content. I don't want stuff in the header, the footer, nav, or anything else. So these are all. You can see these content links here. So I'm going to go down to, let's see, footer. Whoops, not footer four, please. Hold on, be good. If my fingers would work, this would be a whole lot better. All right, so we're at the bottom of the content down here. So I'm going to get rid of all of these things here. All those are going bye-bye. So now we're just dealing with content links. And there's three columns we care about, the from, the to, and the anchor text here. So I'm just going to widen these up so you guys can see. And then I'm going to take this and I'm going to sort it based on the to page. So the page that links are going to, because we're going to look and see what's coming into that page, and we're going to look at the anchor text. Okay, so you guys can see this. So right here, this is the home page for Red Plains Plumbing here in Oklahoma City. And you can see that their anchor text coming into their home page is what? It's blank. This is a very common thing that you see in WordPress themes, that it will automatically build links to, your home page and certain pages that'll have, your blank anchor text or read more or skip down to content. All of those kind of things are there. So, what's the story that, Red Plains is telling Google about their homepage based on their internal anchor text? That it should be ranking for blank. A little bit further down here, faucet, fixture repair, and installation. Notice that what it's doing is it's utilizing the title of the page. How many of you guys ever search for faucet and fixture repair slash installation is your keyword? Anybody? Let's go look it up. Let's just copy that and see what goes on, see what pulls up. See, and blah, 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 slash, it's Red Plains Plumbing because they're the only ones that has that in their title. But if we looked at the search volume on this, let's see, what is the search volume on this? Zero searches a month. Zero cost per click. It's not a really great keyword. So let's go back here to Red Plains. So one of the things that I would do is I would sit there and say, okay, what is the keyword that I want this page to rank for? You know, it's faucet repair, fixture repair. So let's just say it was faucet repair. I would sit there and say, all right, faucet repair, you know, fixture repair. And then I can go highlight these as changes that I want to make. And you can do this, you know, throughout the rest of them too. You can take, for example, your Search Console data, and you can say, what, you know, what keywords am I getting impressions for? And you can use the ones with most impressions and go change these anchor text. So then you go into the, you know, your hot water heater repair page, and where it links to the faucet fixture repair, you just change the anchor text on it in the content, rewrite it just a little bit. And then you have a very much clearer picture of what you want that page to rank for. Coming down here a little bit further. You know, so all of these are hot water heater repair. You know, what would be wrong with, you know, hot water tank repair, you know, water heater repair, those kind of, does that make sense? You guys, you know, does this make sense to you guys? Don't have me call you out
100%.
Individually. All right, cool. So all you're looking at is that sort of thing. You want some variety in your anchor text, you know, and you want your anchor text to make sense. So here, like with this schedule of service, they actually have schedule A service, schedule online, and schedule service as three different anchor texts coming to this page. That's a good variety there. But most of the rest of these, they just have the anchor text that is, you know, the title of the page itself. And that's not a good thing to do. So this site, you know, I would re-architect almost all of the anchor text because they just used a lazy plugin to build what they've got there. So here's another one. Let's go. Let's see. Carving
go
junkie.
To our actual page and let's see where those links are there.
Yeah, we can do that.
Yeah, that was one of the questions. Is that something you can see on the actual page? Is
yes.
Yeah.
Like hyperlink. Yeah,
so if I go here, yeah, hot water tank. So we'll go this hot water heater repair. So let's come here. Let's open this page. And you can, you know, come through and see the links on the page, or you can go into the you can view the page source.
You don't have a Chrome plugin shows the links?
No. I don't use that stuff because I go around too many pages that I don't care about seeing that stuff. So that's just, so if I go here, let's go and whoops, let's, let me go back to this and see what one I'm looking for. I'm looking for this URL. So let me find that URL. Find. So here's where it's using it. There's a canonical that it's using. Is it reporting to, is it pointing back to itself? Hold on a second. I grabbed the one that's pointing back to itself.
Yeah. Incidentally, if you make those changes in Screaming Frog, will they become permanent to the website itself, or is
no,
that just for
no,
illustration
no.
purposes?
No, it's just going to change. Screaming Frog just crawls the pages and pulls back what's there. It has no ability to change the web pages. Otherwise, it would be the greatest black hat gift ever. You know, I could come and change.
I would do all my competition and get rid of them, the search results, Robert.
Absolutely.
Okay, I'm gonna put a big bucket over my head now.
No. There's no reason to put a bucket over your head.
Okay, you mentioned that
yeah.
Once you link to this, we change the text on the other page where it links to match that keyword.
Yeah. All you're looking at is whether or not, hold on a second. Let me move this around a little bit. Where'd it go? All right. So it's not showing right now in the code. It's not pulling it up the right way. So I'm screwing something up, but yeah, it's just, you go and look at the text in the content and just change it up. So if I wanted to go, I'll just go with something else here. Let me pull, like here, the schedule a service is a button. All right. So maybe instead of schedule a service, give us a call, schedule a consult, schedule a visit, schedule an emergency repair. All of those things can be changed on these sort of things. And in the on this one, it's got your phone number here. Let's see, what else does it have? It's just pulling these things a little differently. So let me go to a second one here. It might be a little easier because some of these sometimes Screaming Frog pulls stuff a little bit wonky. So let's just make sure.
Incidentally, what has more power with Google, the actual URL keywords in the URL or the anchor text or the combination of both, or are they equal? Have you looked into that at all?
All of them are factors. I would sit there and say that I can't tell you the difference between having it as, your keyword as anchor text versus having it in the URL and not in the anchor text. I don't know which one would be, more powerful. I know that both of them move the needle. So, but I haven't tested those two, head to head. So my wife is into wood carving, so I grabbed a wood carving example. I'm going to sort this. We're going to sort it based on link position. So we're just looking at content again. Let's go find footer. Whoops.
And I noticed that you went to content
Yeah.
links, not headers or footnotes. Are content links more powerful than the others? That's why you're concentrating on that type of a link?
Yes, that doesn't mean the other ones are not powerful, but yes, they are more powerful because when you're looking at a page, Google has patents and they describe it. So let me just pull up this page as an example. Okay, so this right here is templated. It's on all pages of the website. And there are other things like your footer tends to be the same across all pages on your website. And sometimes you'll have little widgets over on the side or, navigation over on the side that are the same on all those pages. So all of those things that are templated, Google discounts the impact of those on a page when determining what your page is about. And the central piece of content, which is really what, we put in there as the page, they put more emphasis on it in determining what your page is about. So they put more emphasis on, one second here, on this, content that you see here than on, this navigational stuff, although it still has impact. So all I care about is just looking at the links. And I'll show you in a second, another consideration that I have is what I like links from relevant pages. And we'll talk about that here in a minute. So when you're looking at Carving Junkies here, let me close this up. Let me just sort this based on two, based on anchor text. And let's open these three columns up, which are the ones we care about. Okay. So all the links coming to the homepage, the anchor text is either carvingjunkies.com, but look at this, Facebook. It's linking to itself with Facebook. You're like, well, how the hell could it be doing that? Watch. When you go here to this particular page, and let's find. Come on, where'd you go? Are you in the code only? Oh, it's still loading. Give it a second. All right, it's loading, loading, loading. Love pages like this that are loading. Here's the joint. All right, so see this? Facebook, if we hover. It's a self-referential. You can see it down in the bottom corner that it refers to itself. And in that, there's also the anchor text Facebook, the anchor text Pinterest, So when we see this on Screaming Frog, you'll see Facebook. You'll see all the home links there. You'll see Pinterest and Reddit as anchor text on every page. That anchor text exists because of that design element. So you're telling Google that every page of your site is relevant for the keyword Facebook, Pinterest, and Reddit. Not a good thing. Not a good thing. So here, Beginner's Guide to Wood Carving. This is one of their nice blog posts. You see that all the anchor text pretty much starts off with Beginner's Guide. And then it switches to Beginner's Guide to Wood Carving. And then to Carve Like a Pro, you know, and then of course Facebook and Pinterest and Reddit. And then there's wood carving, and then there's a bunch of blank ones.
Do you think it would be a good idea to get rid of all those extraneous anchor text words in your site and just use the keywords that you're trying to rank for in the content of the site? In other words, you're cluttering everything up with all of these footer notes and things, and that could conceivably confuse Google's bot when it crawls the site and it sees hundreds of, you know, pre-manufactured keywords like Facebook and Pinterest and all that. And that could lower your ranking. Is that possible?
Yeah. I mean, that's kind of the point of this. When you look and say, what's the story that I'm telling Google about this page? Well, some you see is blank, some is Facebook, Pinterest, Reddit. You know, wood carving is, you know, one anchor text that they have, you know, on a page. The question is this the, because there's a whole site about wood carving, you know, so is wood carving appearing on multiple pages? You know, all we have to do is resort this by anchor text and we can find out, you know, if we sort it by anchor text instead of, you know, by the two page, because now we're just looking at that. So let's go here. Let me see. Let's go up and see if we can just find wood carving caricatures, wood carving. So it's only one page. So it's one page that's wood carving and it's the beginner's guide. You know, so we're not seeing multiple pages with, you know, different anchor text. So let's sort this back the other way, because I just like to look at it at a page level.
Do you know if this is a WordPress site or HTML?
They're all WordPress. These are all WordPress sites, pretty much.
Isn't WordPress notorious for using a lot of clutter, links, and footnotes and things? Couldn't those be eliminated from WordPress by using some kind of a plugin, and then just concentrating solely on the content, links, and anchor text?
It depends on the theme. You know, and it depends on, you know, because most of what you're seeing here on these first couple of sites, most of the links created are created just simply by the theme using the title as anchor text. And there's very little other stuff that's done. But sometimes you'll see that the theme or a plugin will create, you know, this Facebook, Pinterest, Reddit, or it'll create, you know, blank anchor text or, you know, things like that. So here's a better one. These are the best gloves for wood carving. And you can see that there's a whole bunch of different anchor text here. They've done a good job of internally linking, you know, carving gloves, how to get gloves for wood carving. You know, I don't know about protect against cuts, but not knife, you know, stabs. I don't know about that as an anchor text. I'd probably, you know, utilize something a little different. Read about it here. You know, not a good anchor text.
Would it be good to keep one anchor text keyword per link? I see here they're mixing a bunch of words, keywords up together in a single anchor text. Doesn't that dilute the power, or should you keep it to one keyword per anchor text?
Well, you want variation, and there's nothing wrong with like how to get the best gloves for wood carving. That's relevant. You know, it's a relevant piece. And somebody might actually search for that, you know, term. It's a long tail term. So it's not bad. And the question is, does this, if you look at this in its entirety, right here, does that tell Google a good bit about what your, you know, best gloves for wood carving page is about? Yeah, it does a reasonable job. Now, there are some things that can be done better. Sure. Are there some things that need to be eliminated? Yeah, Facebook, Pinterest, Reddit, those things, you know, need to be eliminated if possible, you know, from your setup. Or, you know, they need to be directed out instead of self-directing, self-referring back to the page that they're on, you know, direct out to your actual Facebook page, your actual Reddit page, your actual Pinterest page. Those are all fine. Now, the other thing that I look for, so let me go back. Let's go back to Screaming Frog for a minute. This is one that we picked randomly. So now that it's done, you know, crawling, I'm going to sort this by content type. So you can see all these images and things like that. And then I'm going to come down here to the HTML pages. So I'm going to start with this first HTML page here. And I'm going to go all the way down to the end. And that's all the pages. You see them right there. There's not a lot of them. Those are all the HTML pages that they have. Then I'm going to come down here to inlinks. And I'll just export that data. And we're going to save this as, what's the name of this site? Safeguard. So I'm going to call it Safeguard. I'm going to save and open. So this is the one that we picked. They're in Harlingen, Texas. They're ranked number 25, 6, somewhere in there. I'm going to sort this. I'm going to have, so we can get rid of everything that's not content links. So sort it by link position again. Nice and easy. Now this one above the content has, you know, these aside links. Don't care about those. Get rid of them. All right. So we're down at the end, which is good. So now we'll get rid of these. So you see footer, header, nav links, all those things are gone. Now notice there's not a lot of stuff on here. If you just paid attention when I was flipping through there, you're going to see there's not that many links. So you see that there's only 54 rows of data, 55 rows of text. So let's go here, take these three, let's open them up so we can see.
All we're looking for is the content, the position and content, and the hyperlink.
Yeah. So this is the page that it's from. This is the link that it's, you know, page that it's linking to, and that's the anchor text. So this one right here, Safeguard's linking to itself. You know, it's a homepage link. And sometimes you'll see that with jump links or, you know, other things, they'll say skip the content or whatever else. You know, this one's blank anchor text. If I go to their about page, you know, nothing. If I go to their, what page is this? Their company background page. That's one anchor text. The other one's blank. So they've got clearly something in their theme that is, you know, generating a blank anchor text link. You know, you can go investigate that. Here in their contact page. So contact page, call us today, contact us to sign up, request a free inspection, request estimate. Do you want people, you know, requesting an estimate there? Do you want a different page for it? These are all SEO questions that you can ask. But if the contact page is where you request the free inspection or you sign up for stuff, that's not a bad thing. And then you have, looks like, some different city pages, Edinburgh, Harlingen, McAllen, Mission, you know. And then you have a gallery, set of galleries, so image pages. And then their service plans. And if you look at, you know, their service plans, that looks like they're using probably some H2 or section, you know, thing as a anchor text. Don't like these. You know, they're not using a whole lot of internal linking. It's a smaller site, but they're not using a whole lot of internal linking. Do you guys think that you could go in randomly, just log into this site and do a better job with their internal links than what they've got here? What do you think, Alfredo? You think you could do it?
Yeah, 100%. And what I want to know is, okay, these are blank, right? So guys, don't get caught up in like, how many of this, how many of that. Something is better than nothing, first of all. And don't, like, you know, if it's a bunch of the same ones, change that up. But what I want to know, Lee, is like, if we fill those in, do a better job, turn the blanks into something, give variations in there, what is the impact of that?
All right. So what happens is when you have those internal, first off, you're telling all of the search engines, not just Google, you're telling them, a little bit more about what your page is about, how they relate to the other pages. And when what we have found is that when you do that, it can generate a site-wide rise of 10 to 30 positions ranking site-wide. So if you're ranking in the 50s, it might get you into the 20s or teens right away. Because usually if you're ranking in the 50s, it's not just because your internal linking sucks. It's usually your pages are thin, you don't have external backlinks or things like that that are there. But this is a fast fix. And because it can get a site-wide thing, you can also look and see if there's, pages, and I've seen this a lot on sites. Pages where they'll use, for example, plumber, and they'll point it to like nine different pages on the site as internal. Now it's a relevant anchor text, but if Google's looking at your internal anchor text and saying, which page should I rank for plumber? And you're like, well, any of these nine would be fine. No, that's confusing. You don't want to do that. You want your emergency plumbing page to be emergency plumbing contractor, emergency plumbing service as anchor text. So it says, hey, this is the topic of that page. So if I'm looking at here, there's service plans, gold service protection from 11 common pests and a 20-foot perimeter around your home. Is that an anchor text that tells, Google a lot about what this is about? Service plans? Pest control service plans? No.
So would it be best to shorten all those up with keywords, a mixture of your keywords? Like even over in your contact page, all he was using was words like call us, he wasn't mixing any keywords into any of those links in the anchor text. It was like a free inspection calls. Would it be best to put like call us for a pest control inspection today? Making sure that the keyword or your mixture of your
Oh,
top 10 keywords.
absolutely.
Okay.
Absolutely. So here, there's request estimate that goes to the contact page. Let's see, where's call us today? Let's see. Here's call us today. Another, it's a button, but it's there. Call us today. That goes to their termite inspection. So learn more about termite control. Not terrible. But if I'm first off, if I'm doing CRO stuff here, learn more about, no, I'm just like, all about termite control or something that's going to drive a little bit more of the click instead of nobody wants to learn about. We want to get rid of your damn termites today, control your termites today, those sort of things, for anchor text that drives conversion. But from an SEO perspective, you can do better than that, and I would all of these in sort of these little buttons, I would put these things in the content a little bit better than, just having these buttons here. So
Does
here's a great example, like right here. They're in Mission, Texas, pest control. This could be highlighted to link to, the homepage, for example, or Safeguard. Their name could link to the homepage. Let's see if I'm going back up here, termites. That's a great place to link to your termite control page rather than learn more about termite control. Let's get them in the content. Let's do those sort of things. And if I wanted, let's see, there's other more termites. Let's see, is there anything here about types of termites, maybe? And I can modify this text a little bit. So if I wanted, control your termites, you can put that in here. If it's not there, I just modify it. So instead of learn more about termite control, it's like control your termites. As anchor text, here's how to control your termites. That's a link right there. It's not rocket science. Now, I will tell you common questions that I get, and Alfredo started to allude to this. Which particular anchor text do I use? Relevant. It's all I care about. So I'll pull stuff out of Search Console, and if I think that they're good anchor texts and they're ones that I want, that page to rank for, I'll use them. How many times do you use each one? I don't care. Where do you put them? In the content. Do you put them here or there or elsewhere? I don't care. Just somewhere on the page in the content, pointing with that, particular anchor text that I want. Do you
You
have to
know,
use them all? No.
if it's assuming that 99% of the websites out there in the wild web, have not run this frog program on their website, so they're totally clueless. I'm wondering, does anybody have any idea how Google manages to monitor the hundreds of millions of websites that are just full of all of these crazy, weird anchor text and non-anchor text type of links? How it manages to flush all those away and make its determination on what the site is about? Because it seems so confusing with all of these websites that I can hardly understand how Google can find anything that's relevant to what they're actually talking about. By the way, Lee, thank you so much. This is really powerful stuff. I can't tell you how interested I am in this because you're pointing out things that I don't think any of us have ever seen before. How many people have ever run this flaming frog program and figured this out? This is really fantastic stuff.
I appreciate it.
I've never done the Screen Frog, but I've used different anchor links with keywords that were relevant.
Sure.
But I would send them to a page that contained that keyword, and that keyword, it was in the title, but with the city and whatever for contractors, right? In the
Yeah.
city, that keyword in the main title and relevant keywords in the subtitles and whatnot. And we talked about the subject. That's what we did. And well, that's what I do. And looking at the source page of other websites, I've always done that. I always click on that. I
That's
always click
awesome.
on.
And there are certain tools out there. There's Link Whisper, InLinks, these sort of things that can help with that. But there's no automation that's available. Your brain is always going to be more powerful to pick, which anchor text should go to which page. So I was going to say the other question that I get very commonly, you can take a website, particularly larger websites, and do topical clusters. A lot of people do silos, but it's not always silos. Sometimes just topical clusters. So if you have, certain, let's see, what's a good example? If I had a website that was about, plumbing fixtures, so I might have PVC pipe as one particular thing. I might have toilets as one particular thing. I might have, soldering stuff is one particular thing. I might have, copper pipe, as a particular thing. So all of these particular pages that are relevant, I would have them linking to each other. I like links from relevant pages. Now, some people will sit there and say, well, what clustering tool? How do you determine that? I look at it. If I had like Lee's plumbing and electric, because you see a lot of these guys that are contractors that do plumbing, electric, HVAC. And it's all done into one thing. If you got your plumbing page linking over to your electrical page, why? What does an electrical page and a plumbing page have to do with each other? I remove those. I would go through, if I saw on Screaming Frog that electrical page is linking to plumbing pages, I would remove those links from the content. Electrical with electrical, plumbing with plumbing.
I
And
usually tell customers we need two websites, two different websites. So we leave this one for this one and that one for that one, and that's it.
yeah, it's easier to do it that way. It's not always possible, but it's easier to do it that way. Carlos is electric, Carlos is plumbing. Those two things can be just completely thing. But if I look at, Carlos Home Enterprises and we do plumbing and electrical and HVAC, it's like, okay,
Yeah,
so
that's
what are you
different.
really
That's
dominating in? You're less a plumber than just Lee's plumbing. You're less an electrician than Richard's electrical. You're less, an HVAC than Alfredo's HVAC. You're competing against people that specialize in their whole site, and their backlink profile is all designed towards one topic, one niche. So it's really, really hard to, be a multi-niche enterprise, but sometimes it is what it is. So even if you have somebody that's in all of those, just make sure the internal links are siloed and you'll do a better job.
I like
So
that.
that's all right. Other questions? Let me stop share here for a minute so I can see everybody's cheery faces. Yeah, that's kind of the thing. And I was shocked when I ran it on some of my own sites. My wife had done a lot of research on the SEO impact of different WordPress themes. And you find out that there's a lot of WordPress themes that have SEO baked into them. Some of them will create, for example, schema for you automatically, generally badly. Some of them will create internal links on your behalf, sometimes not to pages that you want them to go to, and sometimes not with the anchor text that you would want. So, I look at these sort of themes and plugins. We have just an internal joke. We just start, you'll hear one of us yelling, "Stop helping me," because those things are there. And you see, when you just run a screaming frog on a lot of these sites, you'll look at them and go, okay, nobody's really paid attention to the internal anchor text. And it's powerful. We spend a lot of time thinking about that for our external links, don't we? I want this page on this site with this anchor text. But internally, whatever works. And it's some of the more powerful links that you have is the ability to take control of your own site very quickly and paint a very clear picture about what each page is about and how it relates to the other pages on your site.
Back in 2018, everybody was pushing this idea of mixing up your anchor text, with your site URL, or click here, or maybe mix up a keyword every third or fourth link. But I think what you're telling us here is that because these are internal links, not external links, that you can really concentrate on keywords in your anchor text and ignore all of those kind of fluffy, click here type of anchor text that they were pushing way back when. So are you saying we need to concentrate on your top 10 keywords in the anchor text that are relevant to a particular set of pages and forget about all that, the fluffy ones from the past?
So what I'm saying is, if I look at a particular page, let's say it's an emergency plumbing page. Yes, you can use emergency plumbing internally, a lot as your exact match and so forth, and that'll help. But I find it's better to mix it up. So emergency plumbing services, emergency plumber near me, 24-hour plumber. These sort of variations in there, because all of those anchor texts paint a more complete picture about what your emergency plumbing service page is about. And that's it. And I don't care so much about, there's obviously one keyword that I care about would be emergency plumber or emergency plumbing services, depending on the keyword, the search volume. That's the one that I care about. So I'm going to use that one a little bit more than I use all the rest of them, but I'm still going to use all the rest of them. But I don't have a formula and I don't care, because sometimes I might find, hey, you know what? A couple of these lesser keywords just are already in the content from the page. So I'm just going to grab it. I'm not even going to modify the page. I'm just going to drop an anchor text in there and go. I don't overthink it, because what happens is, if you start thinking about, all right, it's got to be internally 8% exact match, and then 5% your top three alternate variations, and no more than 2% of all that sort of stuff, then you're tying yourself into a system where you're going to spend hours and hours and hours running in circles. And I already have the internal links done on the site, and I'm gone. And I'm going to outrank you. I'm going to beat you, because all of those things that we tend to care about in the perfection get in the way of, can you beat the stuff that I showed you today? And you would be able to. And I showed Alfredo's the other day. Alfredo, tell him your experience with that, man. Because we're just talking about, and I was showing him. He goes, "Oh man, it's cool." I said, "You want to run it on your site?" And he goes, "Sure." So we ran it on his site. So what'd you see?
Yeah, guys, it's crazy, like with these saying, right? We're always like, oh, backlinks and oh, keywords and this and that. Like, do the basic. Like on mine, Like Lee said, like, yes, I test a lot of mine. I show mine on here, what we do and stuff. But on mine, like the basics, right? Multiple blanks, no anchor text on there. And we know that makes a difference, right? Is but and then guys, if first of all, Screaming Frog is free, right? You can take any website, any of your competitor site. So with this here, if you can do a pre-audit, make sure, like Lee says, that your handbrakes are not on the website, right? That it's even indexable. And then the next thing, in fact, I think Lee even said the next thing before you run heat maps, before you run any of that stuff, what are the anchor texts? And you will see a difference in your ranking. Like our friend here that had a question, Ajar, hide, like I'm new, I'm a freelancer. This is exactly what will make a difference in your career and distinguish you to be different, right? Like we heard it here, like, dang, I haven't ran this report. Oh, I don't do this report. Like, I challenge anybody here, go run it on your site, one of your client site that you're struggling with, and watch what happens.
Yeah,
But
Fred, you said you
definitely
showed your.
you're
Oh, go ahead. Finish. Go ahead.
I mean, it's just like you'll be surprised, like Lee said, like, man, am I an SEO and I'm not even covering these basics, leaving this stuff blank and like, what the heck?
I still have yours if you're okay showing it. If you're not, that's fine.
Go
We
for
can.
it. No,
All right,
just do it. Let me pull this up.
incidentally, Lee, this is, these are really great gold nuggets. Do you, is there anything else that you were going to share with us today concerning internal internal affairs of a website, including internal linking, that you would find relevant to this discussion?
Not for now. I was just going to cover the internal links, but let me show you when we ran Alfredo's. And I was like, okay, Alfredo, you SEO dude, you. All right, let's see. So this is Alfredo's. And I love Alfredo for showing this stuff. So let me open up his site. This is already there. So was this yours? Yes, perhaps mine. So, all right, so here's it. Look at this first, the anchor text. Notice that the anchor text are dates. Go into those pages. And then you'll see, let's come down here a little bit. All right, benefits of Google My Business for small businesses. There you go.
Because we all know when you're looking for Google My Business help, you search dates, right?
Yeah. Because when I think December 23rd, I'm thinking Google My Business. That's just it's an automatic.
What, incidentally, Alfredo, what theme are you using on this website?
It's WordPress. Exact theme, I don't remember, but it is
Yeah.
WordPress.
Some I've
So look.
noticed this on my WordPress site. So about half a dozen of these themes that I've been downloading, they insert dates and everything. All the links have a date in them. And that's kind of extraneous fluff, according to Lee.
Well, it
So,
can be, you can have category pages and stuff like that. Like you see here, this is the blogs page pointing to that, the month, it was done in, July of 22. That's fine. So you'll see those read mores and things like that. But is that really, it's always like he's the title. It's just like everybody else, on WordPress and stuff like that. And then once here, he says Google My Business and once small business SEO. But I'm pretty sure if I asked Alfredo, I said, what kind of links do you want? What kind of anchors do you want coming the benefits of, Google My Business for small businesses? He might say small business, GMB for small business, Google My Business, Google Business Profile now, GBP for small business. Those would be the anchor text that he would pick. I'm guessing, Alfredo, am I wrong?
no.
Yeah, that's perfect. But you can see, so you're looking at his site. So here's some other great anchor text choices. Previous and next, love those. So his book a call page has book a call, free consultation. That's not bad. Oh, but look, Google My Business here is going to his Google My Business page. It's also Google My Business's anchor text or his Google My Business for small businesses page. So which is it? You know, which is the one? If we're going to rank your site, one of the pages of your site for Google My Business, which one is it? Well, Alfredo's not clear about that here. Content optimization. We love this one. Content, creating compelling content, keyword rich, learn more. Manage content, optimizing, and search engine optimization.
Alfredo, what would you say your main keyword is for this website? Is it how to create a Google My Business or insights into Google My Business? Or what's the most popular keyword? Have you run that test yet?
Yeah, this is it right here. This is the actual screen for my website. So, you know, that's what we're pointing out on mine. And I'm supposed to be the expert, right? Like, we missed this. And I think this is a huge opportunity on a lot of us. Like, we need to go in there now and switch it up, change it up. Get, like Lee was saying, different variety for small business, local business, plumbers, all of that. Get that, you know, squared away in there, and that will make a difference.
Yeah, this looked like some of my websites too, just to be very, very clear. You know, I'm not pointing fingers and saying, well, if you're all as smart as me. No, I discovered that my dumb ass was doing this stuff too.
In WordPress, you have everything there that you could change dates or whatever that you like. You could even update. You could change your preferences of the way the title is going to be. It doesn't have to be that title. You could give it a different title and you could add dates or you could remove dates. It's all customization.
Exactly. Exactly. Yeah.
And that it was seems a, like that everybody's was making these mistakes. These are huge mistakes on their WordPress sites. There must be hundreds of millions of sites out there that are making these fantastic mistakes about not using any of their keywords in their anchor text. How I mean, just as a theoretical thing, how does Google wade through all of this problem of not being able to decipher what a website actually is about? I mean, it seems like a miracle that Google could come in, scrape the site and say, oh, this site is about immigration attorneys in San Diego or limousines in Los Angeles. It's a miracle that they can ever get any of these websites to rank properly.
Don't think about it as a site. Think about it as a page. Like here, if we're looking at this content optimization, Hesperia, California, notice most of the anchor text here is learn more. And then you've got content, which is also used up here in this page. And it's probably used other pages, you know, internally. And then optimizing the website content, that's good. Optimizing your content, that's good. Content optimization, Hesperia, that's fine. But learn more. Across, you know, most of them. Now, I'll bet you that those are, you know, the if I'm looking at these, let's go back and look at where they're linking from. These are probably just blog pages. No, they're not. They're coming from actual pages, you know, with learn more. So maybe it's a widget. I don't know how, you know, those particular links are, you know, coming in because I haven't looked through them. But, you know, you come down a little bit further, evaluate your lead sources and results you're getting. Look, it's just the title, Google Authority Stack. It's that and learn more, you know, management services. They're there. Oh, here's another Google My Business page that's using that Google My Business as a thing. Google My Business as an anchor text going to this page too. Alfredo, man, what are you doing?
I got a lot of work to do. Absolutely.
Yeah. But when now, I was looking at guys, that, yeah, go ahead.
Does anybody know of a plugin for WordPress that would go through the website and scrape all of the bad, stupid keywords out of there and then leave the links open for inserting keywords? Is there any kind of a plugin for WordPress that does that? Or probably not.
Not that I'm aware of. And even some of the plugins that suggest link targets and anchor text, I would, you know, I always say you can't just automatically accept the suggestions. So especially when you're dealing in local, most of these local sites, you know, have Not much. So I'm going to show you one because the last group that I did this with, we picked a city in Texas and somebody said, ah, let's go barbecue restaurants. And so we went and grabbed, this barbecue restaurant page, and I just ran a Screaming Frog and it ran really, really quick. And after I sort this on link position, you'll notice it's got links in the head and navigation. There are zero content links. Do you understand why this, this particular restaurant is ranking number 30? Yeah, it's real easy to tell.
Bad coffee. Bad
Bad
coffee.
coffee.
I
So,
have a tool
guys.
called Dib. I have a tool called Dib. It analyzes it analyzes traffic and everything, bad links, good links, and everything. And it lets you know. It's called Dib, DIBB. I use it so that I could see what's going on with that customer's website. I also use Authoritas for rank tracking and Indexer for indexing the sites. But I always take care of those links and have that page ready with that those the link the meta so it could link to with keywords. But on the other side, when they if they do click to it, it includes that keyword along with a city page or anything like that.
That's cool. So
Awesome.
something like this, let's say Alfredo was my client. He's got a decent sized site here, a lot of anchor text. So if I had access to his, Google Search Console data, I could go and look and, probably work through page by page, figuring out what the anchor text ought to be and, what they shouldn't be and that kind of stuff. And I could mark up this Excel spreadsheet. And just have another column for what the anchor text should be, or maybe I'll change the link to red if I want it taken out, or green if it's fine, yellow if I need to change it and what I need to change something to, or if I need to add some, a link to a page. And then I can hand that off to a VA and they can go page by page and just make the changes. It's not hard. It'll take a little while. It would probably take me with Alfredo's site here, maybe a couple of hours to go through and clean that up. And then it would take a VA probably, a good half day to go in and make those changes across all those pages. And then all of a sudden we sit back and guess what's going to happen to Alfredo's site? It's going to rank better. Google will come back and recrawl those pages. It'll understand, what they're truly about, and the anchor text is an important piece of that puzzle. And it'll go, okay, I see what you're doing there. And you'll watch, he will get higher rankings and more impressions for more keywords because of those sort of changes. That's what we've seen. It's not the answer. It's not the thing, oh, you do this and you're going to be number one. No, that's bullshit. But it is something that fixes a lot. And then when you start to go in and actually SEO the pages that need additional help, or you build the links to them, then you're just powering up the relevance across the entire site. And in local, man, I've looked at a lot of local sites. I'm telling you what, this is easy pickings for you guys. So, questions?
So guys, we're coming up to the 60-minute mark. Let's get our last questions on there. I want to make sure I respect everybody's time, and I hope you guys really leverage this tool. I think it'll make a huge, huge difference. Fast, simple, and effective that will make a difference, right? Best practices, for sure. Lee, if we want to show you some love, those that are watching you would love to learn more about you. Where can they follow you? Where can they learn more about what you're at? And do you have
There's three
anything that they can go watch?
places that you can see me, and only three places. One is SEO Fight Club. For those of you know, it's a show we do on YouTube every week. It's been going for several years. I'm one of the co-hosts. We do SEO presentations, we do Q&As, we do a whole bunch of different things there. The second, I have a training program that I run called Tested SEO Training. That's what Alfredo was talking about, earlier. And if you're interested, you can go and check out and see if it's for you. And the other place you can look for me is witcherlabs.com. Witcher Labs is the place where we've got tools and other little things, like I'm putting together a little mini training like this one that'll be on Witcher Labs, to help people with their internal linking. We'll show a little bit cleaner some of the stuff, and some of those tips and tricks, and those trainings will be free. I mean, basically all you're gonna have to do is give me your email address to get access to it. But you guys got me here live today, so it's a little different. And those are the three places where you can find what I'm up to. Witcher Labs, we've got a link building tool, we've got an indexer that we're developing, and we've got some other tools and things that are coming down the pipeline later this year. So if you want to see what I'm working on and what's working in the labs, that's where you can find it.
So I put that in the comments, in the chat box here, guys. Please go visit Lee. You won't be disappointed. You will definitely learn a little gold nugget. Apply this stuff, apply this stuff, apply this stuff. It will make a difference for you. Now, Lee, before I let you go, I always ask one last question of all our guests.
Let me, before you hit me that question, I'm gonna say one thing, then you get that question. One thing.
Yes.
Don't overthink
Yeah.
this shit. Don't overthink this shit.
That's right.
Because you're looking at, I can go in here blindly and change Alfredo's stuff and do a better job internal linking than has been done thus far. And I do, it's not a disparaging thing with Alfredo, it's just what we do. It's what I've done on my site. So when you look at these internal things, don't get hung up on, the frequency and the amount and which pages, eyeball it. If they're related, link them. If they're not, don't. That's the whole thing. And just do it fast and dirty, because you're fast and dirty, even partially wrong, is better than what's there now. You'll win.
Yes,
Promise.
100%,
All right,
100%.
last question.
So last question, Lee. What is a fun fact about you that nobody knows?
That nobody knows.
Yes.
Okay. Probably nobody here knows that I had a sort of a dual life growing up. I was a actually nobody here knows this one. I grew up in high school, went to private high school, going through, and I was just quiet, a little nerdy kid and stuff like that. And by night, I made my money hustling pool. I was very, very good at it. And I did it for years until I saw one of my friends got cut up going out in the parking lot to collect for a debt. And I'm like, yeah, you know what? I'm gonna do a career change. So that was me growing up.
That's
So kind of a risky business thing, by day, quiet little nerdy student, and by night, pool shark.
Hey, nice, nice. That is a fun fact. Love it, guys. Guys, I appreciate everyone that's on here. Lee, much love and success.
Thank
I
you for
hope
having
we'll
me,
see
man.
each
Thank
other
all of you guys.
tomorrow. Yeah, I appreciate everyone that's here. With that being said, much love and success, and I'll see you on the next one. Take care, guys.